So this session is about mathematics in CT in mathematics. So first presentation will be by Yogesh Sharma, and the topic is From Theory to Practice, Implementing Computational Thinking Through Graphs in Mathematics. Welcome.
Hello. आप सभी को मेरा नमस्कार। मैजिशियन वाली फीलिंग आई। मेरा नाम है योगेश शर्मा। मैं गुजरात के खेड़ा जिले के गलतेश्वर तहसील के एक सरकारी स्कूल पीएमसी स्कूल थर्मल में एज अ मैथ साइंस टीचर के बतौर कार्य करता हूँ। मेरे स्कूल में टोटल 1 to 8 स्टैंडर्ड है और हम 14 शिक्षक हैं, और स्टैंडर्ड 8 में टोटल 92 स्टूडेंट आई हैव इंक्लूड। माय सब्जेक्ट इज़ फ्रॉम थियरी टू प्रैक्टिस, इम्प्लीमेंटिंग कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग थ्रू ग्राफ्स इन मैथमेटिक्स। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज। ओके ओके, थैंक यू। मेरी जर्नी शुरू हुई थी दिसंबर 2022, जहाँ पर हमारी कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग की एक सेशन हुआ था, ट्रेनिंग हुई थी, और वहाँ से हमने कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग क्या है वो सब हमने जाना था, और वो सब जो एक्टिविटीज़ थी हमने बच्चों को क्लासरूम में करवाई थी, और उसके कारण ही लास्ट ईयर भी मैं इसका पार्ट रह चुका हूँ। सो दिस इज़ माई सेकेंड कॉन्फ्रेंस, एंड मैं मैथमेटिक्स का टीचर हूं, तो डेफिनेटली मैथमेटिक्स को कैसे सिटी के साथ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन करते हैं उसके बारे में मैंने सोचा था। तो फिर जो क्लास 8 का चैप्टर है कि आलेख का परिचय, उसको कैसे सिटी के साथ इन्वॉल्व किया जा सकता है, तो उसको लेकर जो आलेख का परिचय उसको मैंने सिटी के साथ इन्वॉल्व किया था। तो सबसे पहले जो बच्चों का जो टेस्ट हुआ था, यूनिट टेस्ट, उसमें देखा था कि इस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर में बच्चों के, बहुत सारे बच्चों के मार्क्स थोड़े कम थे, तो मैंने ये सोचा कि इसको क्यों नहीं सिटी के साथ सिखाया जाए। तो उसके लिए मैंने एक वर्कशीट तैयार की थी जिसमें कुछ टास्क दिए गए थे, और उस टास्क को बच्चों को फॉलो करना था, और कुछ क्वेश्चन से उसको क्वेश्चन को उनको आंसर देना था। तो बच्चों को सबसे पहले मैंने डाइवर्स ग्रुप में डिवाइड कर दिया था, ताकि जो हायर अचीवर स्टूडेंट है और लो अचीवर स्टूडेंट है, उन सबका एक डाइवर्स ग्रुप बना दिया था गया था, और सबको अलग अलग ग्रुप में बिठाकर ये वर्कशीट दी गई थी। वर्कशीट ऐसे डिज़ाइन की गई थी कि जो सिटी के कंपोनेंट्स है हमारे डेटा कलेक्टिंग और डेटा एनालिसिस, उन सब का इस्तेमाल वो आसानी से कर सके। तो बच्चों को जो वर्कशीट थी, वर्कशीट का कैसे इस्तेमाल करना है, उन सबको पहले उदाहरण के साथ दिखाया गया था, और बाद में बच्चों को अलग अलग वर्कशीट दी गई थी, और उसके बाद जो टास्क दिए गए थे वो टास्क के अनुसार जो बच्चे थे, बच्चों वो अपना डेटा है वो डेटा कलेक्शन करते थे, ग्राफ ड्रॉ करते थे, और उसके बाद जो क्वेश्चन थे उस क्वेश्चन का आंसर देने के लिए वो ग्राफ का एनालाइज करते थे। जो सिटी के हमारे कंपोनेंट से है डेटा कलेक्शन और डेटा एनालिसिस, जिसमें जो भी टास्क था वो टास्क के अनुसार उनको डेटा कलेक्शन करना था, जो बच्चे ग्रुप में इकट्ठे होकर एक दूसरे के साथ मिलकर वो डेटा कलेक्ट करते थे, और उसके बाद जो डेटा कलेक्शन हुआ था उसके अनुसार वो ग्राफ को डिज़ाइन करते थे, और उसके बाद जो भी आंसर जो डिज़ाइन किए हुए थे वो आंसर उनको देना हुआ था। यहाँ कुछ एग्जांपल दिए गए, ये स्लाइड जो फोटोग्राफ्स है वो गुजराती में है, आप देख सकते हो। तो उसमें एग्जांपल दे कुछ है मैं देना चाहता हूँ, जैसे कि टू प्रिपेयर ग्राफ टू कलेक्ट द डेटा, जो आपके ग्रुप में जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं उनकी हाइट कितनी है और वेट कितना है, वो डेटा कलेक्ट करें और उसको ग्राफ में डिज़ाइन करें, और जैसे ये जो क्वेश्चन दिए हुए हैं उसको इस क्वेश्चन का आंसर देना होता है, जैसे कि आपके जो ग्रुप में सबसे ज़्यादा हाइट किसकी है, सबसे कम किसकी है, इक्वल किसकी है, वो सब। और दूसरा कि आपका जो डे टू डे आपका टाइम टेबल है, जैसे कि आप कितने घंटा सोते हैं, कितना घंटा पढ़ते हैं, कितना घंटा आप स्कूल में रहते हैं, कितना घंटा आप टीवी मोबाइल वो सब देखते हैं, तो वो डेटा कलेक्ट करके फिर उनको वो ग्राफ डिज़ाइन करते थे और क्वेश्चन का आंसर देते थे। ये जो वर्कशीट थी उसमें कुछ होमवर्क भी हमने दिया था, जैसे कि यहाँ पर एक है कि आपके घर पे लास्ट 5 मंथ्स का जो लाइट बिल आता है, तो लाइट बिल में आपके कौन से महीने में कितना यूनिट आपने यूज़ किया, कितना आपका खर्चा हुआ, पैसे कितने हैं, तो वो सब डेटा कलेक्ट करके लाते थे और उसको जो भी क्वेश्चन है, जैसे कि कौन से मास में आपका सबसे कम लाइट बिल आया था, कौन से मास में आपका सबसे ज़्यादा लाइट बिल आया था, वो क्यों ज़्यादा आया था, क्यों कम आया था, वैसे ही सब जो एनालाइज करना होता था वो सब बच्चे करते थे। चैलेंजेस एंड वेरिएशन की बात करें तो कुछ जो बच्चे थे वो जो लोअर अचीवमेंट वाले बच्चे थे वो शायद डेटा देना नहीं चाहते या फिर वो नहीं दे पाते थे, तो उसको हमने सॉर्ट आउट करने के लिए जो ग्रुप में बच्चे थे, जो हायर ग्रेड वाले बच्चे थे, उनके साथ मिलकर वो सारे जो डेटा थे उनको एनालाइज करने में और कलेक्शन करने में साथ में उनको जोड़ा था। ये सब टेस्ट जो हुआ था वो ख़त्म करने के बाद हमने पोस्ट टेस्ट भी लिया था, तो आप ग्राफ में देख सकते हैं, ग्राफ थोड़ा गुजराती में है लेकिन मैं आपको समझा देता हूँ। जो मैथ्स की टेस्ट ली तो जो ब्लू ग्राफ है, ब्लू लाइन है, वो प्री टेस्ट है और जो ऑरेंज लाइन है वो पोस्ट टेस्ट है, राइट। तो प्री टेस्ट है उसमें आप देख सकते हैं कि 28% स्टूडेंट उतने ही थे जिन्होंने सिर्फ 50% से ज़्यादा स्कोर किया था, और 27% स्टूडेंट ऐसे थे जिन्होंने बिलो पासिंग मार्क्स परफॉर्म किया था। लेकिन सिटी को इम्प्लीमेंट करने के बाद और ये पोस्ट टेस्ट लेने के बाद 43% ऑफ द स्टूडेंट उन्होंने 60% से ज़्यादा स्कोर किया था और 9% का जो पासिंग स्कोर था उन्हें में ज़्यादा इजाफा हुआ था। तो सिटी को यूज़ करने का बहुत अच्छा रिजल्ट हमको देखने को मिला। कंक्लूजन की बात करें तो जो बच्चे थे जो मैथ्स का फोबिया था, मैथ्स को ज़रा दूर रहते थे, वो ज़रा अच्छी तरह से प्रैक्टिस करके साथ में जुथ में मिलकर सब सीखने लगे। जो मैथ्स का उनको जो भी बर्डन लगता था वो बर्डन एक दूसरे के साथ मिलकर वो बर्डन उन्होंने कम किया, और सिटी के साथ सीखने के बाद उन्होंने थोड़ा एंजॉयबल और बहुत अच्छी तरह से किया। सो थैंक्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी, थैंक्स टू CTIS एंड SSA एंड TCS टीम, थैंक यू। एनी क्वेश्चंस?
थैंक यू। एनी क्वेश्चंस? सो या थैंक यू सो मच। वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट बृंदा पटेल एंड शीज एंड सलुजीना, they are going to present on the topic computational thinking for exploring the concept of divisibility rules.
Good afternoon, namaste, mera naam patel brinda hai, main gandhinagar gujarat se hu, मेरी स्कूल का नाम सालूजीना मुवाड़ा प्राइमरी स्कूल है। आज का मेरा टॉपिक है कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग फॉर एक्सप्लोरिंग द कंसेप्ट ऑफ डिविजिबिलिटी रूल्स। क्या से नेक्स्ट? हमें पता है कि बच्चों को दूसरे सब्जेक्ट की कंपैरिजन में मैथ्स में थोड़ा कम इंटरेस्ट रहता है। तो जब मैंने ये टॉपिक पहले पढ़ाती थी तो बच्चे उसमें कम इंटरेस्ट लेते थे, फिर क्या होता था कि जो कीज़ है वो याद रखने में उसको प्रॉब्लम रहती थी, डिविजिबिलिटी कीज़। और जब मैंने CT की हेल्प ली और वो मेरे लिए भी चैलेंज था कि मैं कैसे ईजिली उनको एक्सप्लेन कर पाऊँ, तो फिर मैंने सीटी कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग की सहायता से एक गेम थ्रू ये टॉपिक पढ़ाने का प्रयास किया तो मुझे काफ़ी हद तक हेल्प मिली और बच्चे ज़्यादा इन्वॉल्व रहते थे उसमें और अच्छी तरह से कर पाते थे और मैंने ये गेम थ्रू पढ़ाने का प्रयास किया है। नेक्स्ट, ये गेम के स्टेप्स है सब, मैं जब गेम लूँगी तब आपको ये स्टेप्स दिखा दूँ। यस, तो कैसे करते हैं गेम? गेम में क्या करना है कि पहले जो कीज़ है वो कीज़ को फोर ग्रुप्स में डिवाइड कर देते हैं। फोर ग्रुप्स में डिवाइड करने के बाद जब वहाँ एक बच्चा खेलने के लिए आएगा तो एक बॉक्स रखा होगा, उसमें से वो एक नंबर, जो चीट आएगी उसमें एक नंबर होगा, वो नंबर लेके वो चार ग्रुप में जाएगा। पहले ग्रुप में क्या करना है, पहले ग्रुप में 2, 5 और 10 तीन कीज़ होगी, उसको आइडेंटिफाई करना है वो यूनिट प्लेस के हिसाब से। लास्ट जो वंस का प्लेस है उसके हिसाब से हम करेंगे। तो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं कि ये जो नंबर है वो 2 से डिविजिबल होता है, मतलब कि जो तीन बच्चे हैं वो एक 2 की कीज़ लेके खड़ा होगा, 5 की और 10 की। फिर यहाँ पे आइडेंटिफाई करेगा तो जो कीज़ से वो डिविजिबल होगा वो नीचे जो रेक्टेंगल वाले स्पेस एरिया में आ जाएगा। उसके बाद सेकंड ग्रुप में जाता है, वहाँ पे क्या करना है कि हम जो नंबर है उसका जो डिजिट है उसका सम करते हैं। उसके बाद वहाँ पे तीन बच्चे होंगे, 3, 6 और 9 की कीज़ लेके खड़े होंगे। वहाँ पे हम देख सकते हैं कि वो नंबर जो है उसका 24 सम आता है, तो वहाँ पे 3 और 6 से डिविजिबल होता है, तो वो दोनों बच्चे यहाँ पे जो रेक्टेंगल वाले स्पेस एरिया में आ जाएंगे। फिर जाता है तीसरे ग्रुप में, वहाँ पे क्या करना है, वहाँ पे डिजिट लास्ट 2 डिजिट से 4 की कीज़ डिविजिबल होती है और लास्ट 3 डिजिट से 8 की कीज़ डिविजिबल होती है, तो वहाँ पे हम देख सकते हैं कि ये 4 और 8 दोनों से डिविजिबल होता है। फिर लास्ट में 11 की कीज़ है, 11 की कीज़ में क्या करते हैं, ऑड और इवन प्लेसेस का सम करके उसका डिफरेंस लेते हैं और वहाँ जो वो 0 या 11 या उसके मल्टीप्लिकेशन में आता है तो वो उससे डिविजिबल होता है। यहाँ पे ये नहीं होता है तो वो यहाँ पे वो नहीं आएगा। ये जो है प्रोसेस वो 3-4 बार करेंगे बच्चे तब उसको काफ़ी मज़ा आएगा। नेक्स्ट, यहाँ पे हमने सीटी कैसे यूज़ किया है वो देखते हैं कि पहले क्या करना है, पहले डेटा कलेक्शन मतलब सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन कलेक्ट करनी है, जो वो डेफिनेशन बोलते हैं हम वो कलेक्ट करते हैं, फिर उसको एनालिसिस करते हैं कि कौन सी किससे डिविजिबल होती है, फिर उसके प्रॉपर्टी के हिसाब से उसको ग्रुप करते हैं, मतलब वो डिकम्पोजिशन हो गया कि उसकी जो प्रॉपर्टीज़ है वंस के प्लेस के हिसाब से होता है, फिर डिजिट करते हैं उसका वो जो सम है वो करते हैं, उसके बाद वो तीसरे ग्रुप में अलग करना है, फिर चौथे ग्रुप में, ऐसे वो उसके प्रॉपर्टी के हिसाब से डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स में डिवाइड कर दिया है। फिर पैटर्न फॉलो होती है कि पहले ग्रुप में जो होता है वो फिर वहाँ पे ख़त्म करके दूसरे ग्रुप में आएगा, फिर तीसरे ग्रुप में, ऐसे हर बार वही पैटर्न में काम करना रहता है। और एब्स्ट्रैक्शन, हम देखते हैं कि जो किस से वो डिविजिबल होता है वो रेक्टेंगल वाले स्पेस एरिया में है और जिससे नहीं होता है वो बच्चे बाहर खड़े रहते हैं, तो ऐसे एब्स्ट्रैक्ट हो जाता है कि बच्चों को भी समझ में आ जाता है कि किस कौन सी, ये नंबर जो है वो कौन सी किस से डिविजिबल होता है। ये एक्टिविटीज़ के पिक्चर्स हैं, ये 4 ग्रुप्स जो बनाए हैं वो कलर और शेप उसका थोड़ा अलग लिया है, इसीलिए बच्चों को थोड़ा एट्रैक्टिव रहता है। चैलेंजेस, बच्चे पहले इस गेम को गेम की तरह ही खेलते थे, डिसिप्लिन में नहीं रहते थे, इधर एक ग्रुप में से दूसरे ग्रुप में जाते थे, फिर एक ग्रुप में सारी कीज़ है उसको अप्लाई किए बिना दूसरे ग्रुप में जाते थे, तो शुरुआत में थोड़ा कॉम्प्लिकेशन रहता था, पर 3-4 बार जब प्रैक्टिस की तब बच्चों को भी अच्छा लगा और उसकी थिंकिंग एबिलिटी भी नहीं थी, मतलब वो गांव के बच्चे हो तो उसको थोड़ा ऐसे ग्रुप में रख के काम करने में थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम रहता था, तो इवोल्यूशन में थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम रहता था, पर 3-4 बार जब प्रैक्टिस की तो वो समझ में आ गया। इम्पैक्ट. तो जब ट्रेडिशनल मेथड से पहले मैं पढ़ाती थी ये टॉपिक, ट्रेडिशनल मेथड मतलब कि पहले वो जो सिलेबस में है तो टू की है, तो उससे टू की से पहले समझा दी, फिर उसको तीन चार नंबर से उसको रिविजिबिलिटी चेक करते हैं, फिर फाइव की तो बच्चों को वो एक या दो कीज भी समझ में आता था, फिर सारी कीज उनको समझ में आती नहीं थी. तो ये जब मैंने सीटी की हेल्प ली तो बच्चों को एक साथ सारी कीज समझ में आई और वो लॉन्ग टाइम तक याद रहती थी और ज़्यादा इफ़ेक्टिव लगी मुझे. और इससे क्या था कि उससे दूसरे सब्जेक्ट मतलब दूसरे टॉपिक भी उससे कनेक्ट हो जाते थे. ये हमारा इम्प्रूवमेंट है, यूनिट टेस्ट का रिज़ल्ट है. पहले बच्चों जब सीटी की हेल्प के बिना जब हम करते थे ये एक्टिविटी मतलब सिखाते थे तो उसमें ये रिज़ल्ट था, और आफ्टर एक्टिविटी आप इम्प्रूवमेंट देख सकते हैं. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू बृंदा. एनी क्वेश्चंस? थैंक यू. सो नेक्स्ट विल बी presented by Dr. Balaji, but since he is not able to make out in person, he has sent the video, so now we will play the video.
Sixth conference on computational thinking in schools. Welcome to this conference. My presentation's title is Developing Computational Thinking Through Maths Puzzles. Name of the presenter, Dr. Balaji Sudhakar Rao Zapade. My school's name is ZPCPS Palasgaon, Taluka Vasmat, District Hinguli, from Maharashtra. Number of students and grades in my school, there are 295 students and 7 grades. Teachers or math or computer teachers, Mr. Khade sir and Mr. Giri sir are there in my school who teaches maths or computer as well. Number of teachers are involved in computational thinking program, that the number is 4, and number of periods per week for computational thinking approximately 2, but not very specific because the program is maximum conducted in the intervals or the recess period. Activity implementation. Here I would like to demonstrate or detailing this presentation in Marathi. So I have typed Devanagari Lipi here. I would like to say something in Marathi also. काही विद्यार्थ्यांना जेव्हा मी शाळेत प्रवेश घेतला तेव्हा गणितात आवड होती. बहुतांश विद्यार्थी गणित विषयापासून दूर होते, त्यांना गणिताची भीती वाटायची, पण त्यांना गणित आवडायला पाहिजे होता यासाठी काहीतरी करण्याची, काहीतरी धडपड करण्याची संधी माझ्यासाठी चालून आली होती. त्यासाठी मी त्यांना गणित विषयामधील खेळ, गणिती कोडी या रूपात सहभागी करून घेतले, आणि लवकरच त्या विद्यार्थ्यांमध्ये काही तार्किक विचार, समस्या निराकरण, आकृतीबंध तयार करणे, आकृतीबंध ओळखणे, नवनिर्मिती करणे अशा वेगवेगळ्या गोष्टींचे पडसाद आणि चांगले परिणाम मला दिसायला लागले. यातूनच हे माझं कार्य सुरू झालं. विविध आकृतीबंध तयार करण्यासाठी जिओमेट्रिकल शेप्स, वर्ग आणि घनांच्या पद्धती, गमती जमती, पाड्यांमधील आकृतीबंध, त्यामधील गमती जमती, मोठे मोठे पाडे कसे तयार करावे याच्या गमती जमती आम्ही समजून घेत गेलो. दररोज एक गणिती कोडे, आजचा प्रश्न, चला डोके चालवू या पद्धतीने फलकावर लिहून विद्यार्थ्यांना असे प्रश्न सोडवण्यास उत्तेजित केलं गेलं, प्रोत्साहित केलं गेलं. आजचा नवीन प्रश्न काय आणि आज आपल्याला कुठली मेजवानी मिळते यासाठी विद्यार्थीच नव्हे तर शिक्षक देखील उत्सुकतेने वाट पाहत होते. प्रसंगानुसार गणिती खेळ जसे की टॅनग्राम, टॉवर ऑफ हॅनॉय, पॅटर्न ब्लॉक्स, जोडो ब्लॉक्स, इंटीजर टाइल्स, अल्जेब्रा टाइल्स, जिओमेट्रिकल शेप्स, त्रिकोणी संख्या, चौरस संख्या इत्यादींचा उपयोग करत मुलांना कृतीयुक्त विचारांची आणि तार्किक कौशल्यांचा वाव देण्याची संधी, आकृतीबंध खेळण्याची, चिकित्सक विचार करण्याची संधी उपलब्ध करून दिली गेली. एक उदाहरण द्यायचं असेल तर टॉवर ऑफ हॅनाई या खेळातून तार्किक विचार आणि आकृतीबंध ओळखण्याचा सराव दिला गेला, ज्यामध्ये 6 चकत्या असतात. त्या टॉवर ऑफ हॅनाईमधील दोनच नियम आपण पाळायचे असतात, एकावेळी एक चकती उचलणे आणि कुठल्याही परिस्थितीत छोट्या चकतीवर मोठी चकती न ठेवणे. हा खेळ खेळता खेळता सुरुवातीला आनंद निर्मिती, नंतर तार्किक विचार आणि त्यातून गणिती सूत्रांची निर्मिती या ठिकाणी केली जाते. चॅलेंजेस अँड व्हेरिएशन हे सर्व करत असताना साहित्यांची उपलब्धता विद्यार्थ्यांच्या संख्येच्या प्रमाणात करता येणे ही एक चॅलेंज माझ्यासमोर होतं. सोबतच सर्व विद्यार्थी लगेचच या आकृतीबंधांना त्या सूत्रांना समजून घेऊ शकतात असं म्हणता येत नाही, त्यामुळे त्यांना अपेक्षित वेळ देणे ही देखील आपल्यासाठी एक चॅलेंज असतं, कारण दररोज नित्यनियमाने तसा वेळ काढणं प्रसंगानुसार आपल्याला शक्य होत नाही. या ठिकाणी काही फोटोरूपातील आठवणी, क्षणचित्र आणि विद्यार्थ्यांनी केलेल्या कृती मी दाखवल्या आहेत. जसं पायडेची आहे, फलकावरील कोड्यांची आहे, टॉवर ऑफ हॅनाईची एक प्रतिमा या ठिकाणी दिसते आणि मुलांनी त्रिमिती आकार जे बनवले होते त्या व्हिडिओंची छोटीशी कोलाज केलेली फोटो या ठिकाणी मी दिली आहे. याचा परिणाम कसा झाला आणि आता फलक काय मिळाली आहेत ते आपण पाहूयात. विद्यार्थी आणि शिक्षक कॉम्पिटिशनल थिंकिंगबाबत गणिती कोड्यांच्या माध्यमातून गणितात रुची घ्यायला लागले आहेत, त्यात सक्रिय झाले. ज्या वर्गात माझे प्रत्यक्ष जाणे झाले नाही अशाही वर्गातील मुले विद्यार्थी त्यांच्या शिक्षकांना आग्रह धरतात आणि असे गणिती खेळ किंवा कोडे देण्यास पुढाकार घेतात, ते देण्यास त्यांना भाग पाडत असतात. यासाठी काही पुस्तकांचा, संदर्भ ग्रंथांचा उपयोग नक्कीच केला गेला, जसे की पालकनीती नवनिर्मिती फाउंडेशनचे नियतकालिक आहे, नवनिर्मितीतील संसाधन केंद्रामधील काही साहित्य जसे की आपण टॅनग्राम किंवा टॉवर ऑफ हॅनोई म्हणतोय ते त्या ठिकाणून घेतले गेले होते. गणिती खेळ, गणितातील कोडी अशा पुस्तकांचा देखील या कार्यासाठी रेफरन्स घेऊन मी हे उपक्रम नित्यनियमाने चालू ठेवत असतो. आपण सर्वांनी हे माझं प्रेझेंटेशन ऐकल्याबद्दल आपण सर्वांचे धन्यवाद. थँक्स ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर लिसनिंग दिस प्रेझेंटेशन. थँक्यू.
Since he is not available in online, we will not be able to ask any questions. So we shall move on to the next presentation by Dr. P. Satish Kumar and Sirisha on counting of triangles.
Good afternoon. Already you have lunch over, so everybody tight. Shubh Dupara in Marathi. Having a wonderful day. I came from Andhra Pradesh, APSWRS school. I am TGT Mathematics. Actually, I have not interest in any type of mathematics, especially CT strategies. Why? Because first of all, the topic did not know. What are the strategies? What are the approaches? These are all confusing. Later then, one day, a newspaper, there is a puzzle, Sudoku. I can't understand, but I have MSc, MPhil, BAd, MA, PhD also, but there is no logical thinking in my brain. In last few days back, Surya Kumar Yadav was caught by a beautiful catch by Miller. So India won up. India has won. So this enjoyment can be occurred while I teach in CT strategies in my classroom. And further also, recently Kalki movie, here hologram technology, the Prabhas will be different shades. Don't deviate the topic. Please encourage me. 2 minutes fun. So we are exciting all of the enthusiastic classes because of there is a what is the 2 into 3, 2 threes are 6. 2 into 3, 2 threes are 6. Next day I forgotten. That is the student strategy. Whenever this strategy, this logical thinking can be applicable to the students, they were overlap the all strategies. CT is a process which tackle the, which a beautiful solution. Just like Pune, yesterday my friends go to Lunavala. Here a breezy air and a favorite monsoons. There is all enjoyment yesterday. So that's why CT strategies is also a beautiful platform to develop the student career and logical thinkings. Here my presentation. In competitive examinations, just 1 minute. In this session, while I was boring this lesson, when I and my friends going to Ananthapuram IMF training. So that is Ignite My Futures. Varsha and Krupa madam, they were told extraordinary manner. That's, yes, I can change my life pattern into CT strategies. That is the first platform to develop the CTs. Here, so many allegations are there. First of all, in competitive examinations, I can't solve this problem. How many triangles are there? I can suggest 1, 2, 3. Oh, there are 3 triangles, but the answer is false. So that's why there is some beautiful technique behind the story. That is, first of all, how we did the activity implementation. One student come, what is the triangle? How many triangles are there? 1. Next one, here, inside in another triangle. That is, how many triangles? There are 3, 4, etc. Likewise, I develop, what is the methods? 4 into 1 plus 1, that is one simple algorithm. And the second one, there are 2 inscribed triangles. And third one, there are 3 inscribed, such ways we have to develop the patterns. Therefore, and the second one, in a square, there are so many triangles are there. First, I take one square. Here, the number of blocks. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4 are 4 blocks. Into the blocks into diagonals is said to be the number of triangles. That is one of the reason. Here I can develop the strategies. Here already this session is over. I have one doubt. Sir, what is the value of, how did the value 18? That is here, first of all, first square it having 8 triangles. Second one is 8. And moreover, here one triangle is there. If 2 squares are combined, then 2 triangles are there, then totally triangles are 18. Likewise, just you can continue the program. Here, using CT strategies through decomposition and data collection and so many patterns and also formulate the equations. And moreover, here activity implementation, what is the formula for inscribing a triangle? That is a 4 into n plus 1. So number of triangles in a square, that is equal to the gaps into triangles. Here, already we have so many borrowed lessons in a classroom. While I can complete my syllabus. In routine manner, we can develop these strategies. The children, hold the children, enter the APSWRS team, will enjoy a lot by using CT strategies. And thankful to Sonia ma'am and remaining persons of TCS and remaining persons. So here the challenge is, initially the thinking of embedded triangle science by mathematical patterns were a bit confusing for students. So this method can be developed how many triangles in that area. Here our students last 2 weeks back, 2 months back, they were prepared innovation project while doing greenery, some of the solar planets. These are by developing the city strategies. Next. While I completing my lesson counting of triangles, I can give the homework to the students. Some of the student, some ex called me, how many triangles are there? Here, sir, the number of triangles is 5. Entire the class in Archimedes, Eureka, likewise, all the students can loud extraordinary way. So these strategies, especially in Sudoku puzzles, later I teach the in entire the classroom, some of the parents and also some of the other persons will entering into the class, sir, I have a one Sudoku puzzle, that is the interest creating by the CT strategies. Next one. So here, how many here there are lot of models in a triangles in a star or etc. So here number of triangles is n into n plus 2 to n plus 1 by 8. Next. So here one worksheet of the student. The time up is are there, please I can meet another time in not not song, no problem. Impact, though the students response in terms of interest or learning, and also some Sudoku puzzle CT strategies, here all we solve the problems. So first I am a little bit baby, Bahubali, Ramakrishna can lift the baby. After that I am the 6 year child in the CT strategies. Later that I can develop my strategies in future. And thank you for giving great opportunity, entire the whole team of Pune conference, and a special thanks to our family members, because of I was afraid every day, each night I have prepared 1 hour, 2 hour night. My missus was afraid why. So special thanks to my TCS volunteer P Ravi Shankar garu, which coordinate to entire the this program, and also our beloved principal, and also my AMO garu and DCO garu, and wonderful support for Sonia ma'am and remaining persons and whole team. Thank you, and also we love Pune. Thank you.
Chala, thanks Andish. Any questions? Thank you, sir. Next presentation is by Hemalata, and she'll be presenting on guess a number.
Good afternoon, everybody, and good afternoon all of you, all dignitaries and the participants. I am G. Hemalata from APRS WRS Gopalpuram, and from Andhra Pradesh. Okay, I feel I am very thrilling to do here and experience the developments of computational thinking. I have improved my competency and professional skills. Now you are maybe thrilled as like me by this presentation. Maybe I think, okay, let us start. My topic is guess a number. In this activity, okay, let us start. I will show one by one. I will show six boxes with numbers. Okay, please see all the six boxes. One choose a number, then I will say that choose a number. Okay, box one. This is box one. So same like that, box one, box two, box three, box four, like that, box six or some numbers. Okay, please, anyone choose a number from 1 to 63 in your mind? Please, can you choose? Okay, can you choose one number? Choose. Okay. Please come. Thank you, sir. So please choose a number from 1 to 63 in your mind. Yes. Okay, sir. Thank you. Is it in box 1? Yes. Okay. Is it in box 2? Yes. Is it in box 3? No. Same like, is it in box 4? Yes. Okay. Is it in box 5? No. Is it in box 6? No. Box 6 is no. So your number is in B1, B2, B4 and B5 and 4 boxes. B1, B2 yes. And B4 yes. And B5? B5 no? Only 3 boxes. So your guessed number is 11. Yes. Okay. Thank you, sir. The logic of the, do you know anybody the logic of the this question? Okay. One more example. So anybody come? Take another one. Okay, can you choose a number? Okay. Is it in box 1? Okay. Is it in box 2? No. Is it in box 3? No. Is it in box 4? Yes. Is it in box 5? Okay. Box 6? Your number is 57? Am I right? Okay, thank you. Thank you for participating with me. Do you know anybody the logic of this activity or game? Are you okay? Please stand up. Yes, ma'am. It's a makeup of some patterns, ma'am. Patterns, ma'am. Okay, exactly then. No, ma'am. No. Yes, ma'am. Akka. In the okay, like that. In the box number, first of all, I will say the logic of the number. Logic is the if I'm asking in box one, box two, he say or they say yes. So I add the first digits of the those boxes. For example, in first one, say yes, one. When I showing box one, he say yes. So add one plus. He's also seeing box two, say yes. So add two. And in the box four, what is the first digit? Box four, eight. And box, okay. So the total, 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 8 is 11. That is the logic of the number. Okay, madam. So, okay. So, this is main observations. What are the observations? Thank you. What are the observations in my class? Master, students are very feel bored in the math classes. So, I feel very, very, I feel very hard to handle math classes. So that's why I implement this type of logical thinking. Students feel very happy how to guess the question, how to make the answer, how to prepare the puzzle. So students keep like that. That's why students enjoy the class. That's why so I implement this type of logical thinking in this session with the help of this ETIS team. So once again, thanks to who are giving opportunity to me. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, Hemalata. Any questions for her?
Yeah. My voice is too much. Anything you have thought of teaching integers? Madam? Integers?
Yes.
For class 6. Integers. Yes, ma'am. Do you have any creative idea for that?
Integers? This is not applicable to negative numbers, only positive.
Do you have anything with you to share with us?
Okay.
Any idea? It's not okay.
Okay. Negative means less than zero. Okay. Temperature below zero. So how can... So that's why we use the integers. Below positive numbers, zero. Okay. Don't have any activity. Okay. It is only for positive numbers. Okay, thank you.
Any questions on this activity?
So you told us the logic of finding, guessing the number, but what is the logic of creating those boxes? That is the main logic, right?
Thank you. Next presentation will be by Jayalakshmi Ratnakumari on using GeoGebra, proving theorem in circles. Is angle subtended by semicircle is 90 degrees? So she'll be presenting in online.
Good afternoon all of you. Here, myself is Jayalakshmi, coming from Vishakhapatnam district and Ankapalli district. My school name is APSWREI Society and Junior College, Kokirapalli. Here, why I choose this PPT, why? Because some introduction before I give some little bit, 2 minutes of what is mathematics. In our childhood, all of you fear about mathematics. Because in early session, one sir give a speech on the important subjects on mathematics and science. And remaining social studies, all our remaining subjects are lag. Why? Because he gave one important note that communication also, it is very important. That's why these CTIC, these computational all ideas are implemented in our schools, the communication will be developed, he said in early hour sections. Okay. Why? Because we can learn mathematics in different ways, by seeing and doing and hearing and hands-on activity. And that is means, suppose there are some concrete syllabus, means abstract concepts in our mathematics. Here also algebra, like in our mathematics subject, algebra and some branches feel they are difficult to teach. But now these computational thinking used in our that algebra and statistics, data handling, all are, it is very easy. I will prove in this one in geometry. First of all, my state is Andhra Pradesh state. Our school children are most over, means few children are fear about mathematics. They are face so many, this is the contra, means in traditional pedagogy, our teaching strategy mainly different, only face to face. Ask questions to teachers and give the answers up by the students. Now, the changes of Sue Madam, morning session in presentation of online, she says that so many pedagogies are there in our motivation of children, that are now only blended learning in our schools, very important. That is means face to old traditional pedagogy, and this means that blended learning also attached with that strategy, we will achieve more ideas by the students. And our Andhra Pradesh means last year, until last year, all our syllabus is going state syllabus in government schools. Now the last year onwards, the AP states in a few schools are changing. 1,000 schools are went for CBSE schools. That means CBSE means a child, in our child wants to a global child. Means all activities she done, she or the child done very well. That's why, means here, geometry, I will choose geometry because this paper presentation talks about the generalization of practical observations and obstructions. In olden days, means what are closed figures and what are open figures, means children draw the pictures of like that, circles and like triangles, quadrilaterals, types of quadrilaterals, like that. But no one must simply say that, madam or sir, please, the differ, what is the differ of a closed figure and a open figure, means they easily say that the open figure have two endpoints, starting point and ending point. Closed figure, it is only one point, that is the starting point and ending point. The previous slide, that is the triangle and quadrilateral, starting from that and ending that point. That's why those are closed figures. Here are simply say that the differ of closed and open figures. And also say that the differ of 2D shapes and 3D shapes. Here all are 2D shapes, only they have lengths and breadths. But in our, this one is, suppose, this is the like the shape of, yes, in our book also shape of cuboid. Some papers row on one page to page, that is the example of cuboid. Means 2D means 2D shape, another one shape, one quality we add, that we will get 3D shape. Suppose we take that, yes, I in our class, means my class, I observed geometry feels very happy. Ancient times and before 30-40 years, they are enjoyed very lot. Why? Because student doing on hands, draw a circle. So the start with this, with a pencil and draw a circle. Some students, very highly active students are, they are pick up the bangle and draw the circle. And some other students dot a point and took another point. At that point, we get a radius. And that radius, we draw another circle. Nowadays, here means morning, so many lectures in our PPT. That means AI, Meta AI, artificial intelligence, very keep vital role play in our daily life. That's why our in panel net means computer in our mobiles, we download the GeoGebra, we will get easily draw the all geometry figures. That I will give a one chance to suppose here are the our classroom, draw the some girls using their nearby ornaments and some other girls are using our geometry box and some few students means 5 students come to the dais and use IEF panel board and download the already there is a GeoGebra application is there. They are going to that GeoGebra, they draw the circle and next slide madam, draw a circle of your choice means a type of three groups are there. One group IEF panel girls are draw the like the draw the circle of your choice and they go to the GeoGebra and put a dot and next they are draw the any 2 points on a circle means start. Suppose here take that A and B are the points on the circle and suppose take one another point A on an arc of the circle, join the extreme points of a diameter within the point. We already know that because here all are belongings to background of mathematics, only the center through the line is line segment we call that the diameter. That's why here ABC, suppose I took that BC means BC line segment through the A, that is the diameter. Here measure angle in semicircle, what are your observations? Next slide madam. In our GeoGebra means in our we went to our schools, we download the GeoGebra application. Now we go to the first one. Here are basic tools. Here is, this one is the move. We touch that one, we will get move. This A and that A, that like that. Point, we put a point and segment. We add those two. Next slide, please, madam. Draw a diameter of the circle using point and line tools. There are basic tools are there. Line tools, measure tools, line segment, point. All our tools are available in GeoGebra. That's why the children draw the diameter of BC the, through the radius, through the center of the A. That's why this CB is called the diameter. Next slide, please. Next, the diameter. Now, the picture observe that the diameter divides to the circle into two parts. That one is the semicircles of two. Next slide. Join the point on the semicircle and end points of the circle. Here, D, all of you observe that. That also, we use the point, we put a point D and add that BD and CD. We will get a triangle. Next step. We will get a triangle. We measure tool, angle tool, we find it that the D angle is 90 degrees. Next step six, so many students. In third group, 10 students are in our that very intelligent students using in IEF panels. That's where they are draw like this so many examples of means so many, they are take so many lengths of radius and draw the circles and get that and they all are noted in one box. They are observe what is here 3 centimeters, we draw a circle and we draw a diameter and endpoints and triangle. All in all circles and all triangles they will only find that 90 degrees. The angles obtained in a semicircle is 90 degrees. That is the main theme of our mathematics, lastly, final. Okay, madam, next. By the above activity, students are observed. Already I told that in any circle, the subtended angle is 90 degrees. Now, I want to give an assessment for that. Okay, that is a semicircle. Now, I want to measure circle or minor segment circle. When you draw that in any, the angle of minor segment and major segment circles, what you find and observe and write up that notes and review of next day, the girls all are done and they are minor segment circle, they are calculate the angle is obtuse angle. What that? Obtuse angle. In major segment, they are get simultaneously, they are get, there are acute angle, here all obtuse angle. Minor segment, they are get all acute angles, here obtuse angles. Here, nextly, finally, I want to tell that this is the very interesting, so many students are found very, very happy. Madam, it is easily understand. Previous sections means 5 years back before we took a geometry box and use protractor. Some of 50% students confused about how use the protractor. They understand how, where is 90 degrees, the point we put the 90 degrees. They don't know how many teachers says, but they are confused. Here this GeoGebra, we use this GeoGebra, so many theorems and so many constructions also find very easily in our low sections also. My co-author Ratna Kumari madam not here, she also doing very miracles in lower sections, because this is very simple. Anyhow, you went to the go to evening and you download the GeoGebra, easily you put line and line segment, ray, all are taking easy concepts and children very well understanding. Thank you for giving this opportunity for our secretary sir and AMO sir, and madam is our madam is there, and our DCO madam Ropavati madam, and our principal madam Maniki madam. Thank you. And finally, this all happens here. Why I speak here? Because this all belongs to our Sonia madam and Ritika madam. She changes in my PPT some changes were done in Kritika madam and Sonia madam. All help, please give me your Kokirapalli school, give me a task to the, it is implement. Computational thinking is now a vital role. Next coming days, please do your practice in classrooms. She says like that. That's why Sonia madam, thanks, a big thanks to Sonia madam and Kritika madam. Thank you very much for good listeners. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Any questions for her?
Thanks very much. I could see how GeoGebra is inspiring the students. But what about trying to do a proof of the theorem after that? Is there a discussion of the proof of the theorem and how, I mean, do students have, are more inclined to look for a proof or they take it as a fact that the angle subtended is 90 degrees.
But line segment, this was, up to this, all students are learned very well. All students are learned very well. Somehow you say that inclined subtended theorem, that is very, little bit difficult. GeoGebra. Yes. 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 Yes, sir. We can prove any theorem by GeoGebra. Understand very well, because it is easy tool. There is no construction. We draw a put also 50% is done only in that GeoGebra. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other question? Yeah. Thank you. So the fine Sudharani, okay. Sudharani madam. Next presentation is by Sudharani on topic empowering mathematical understanding through constructive learning.
Yesterday and birthday, madam.
a case study of birthday magic square implementation. Such a long.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Sudha Rani, working as PGT Maths in Social Welfare Residential Schools, Karnool. I am very grateful for this opportunity. I am very grateful for this opportunity to present here a case study of birthday magic square using computational thinking. As we know, computational thinking plays a vital role in the development of students, and also our students, they drastically changed their minds beyond their imagination using this computational thinking. As ours is a residential school, students usually celebrate their birthdays in the school itself. So I have chosen this topic to explain through computational thinking, which refers to the thought processes involved in formulating problems and creating solutions. Also, the students, they overwhelmed with joy, and explained the brief explanation of birthday magic square. Now the objective of this is, before slide madam, first slide. The objective of this is to explore the unique properties of magic squares while addressing the complexities, to engage in critical thinking, problem solving, and collaborative discussion to brainstorm solutions, and also to deepen students' understanding of mathematical concepts and enhance their analytical skills in a hands-on learning environment. Next slide, madam. Now, as we know, the famous mathematician birthday lies on 22/12/1887. That is the birth date of Sri Ramanujan. So the birthday magic square was framed on his birthday, on his birth date, that is 22/12/1887. This is a magic square. Now, what is the importance of magic square? Magic square consists of all distinct integers where the sum of every row or the sum of every column and also the sum of the principal diagonal elements will also be the same. See, in the first row, you are having the numbers to be 22, 12, 18, 87. Those four numbers add up to 139. Similarly, the second row elements also add up to 139. And the third row elements are 10, 24, 89, 16. Those also add up to 139. And the fourth row elements, 19, 86, 23, and 11, they also add up to 139. Similarly, the column-wise sum will also be add up to 139. And also the principal diagonal elements. The principal diagonal elements also add up to 139. And also the special feature of this is the sum of the four corner elements is also 139, and also the sum of the middlemost four elements is also 139. That is the important feature of this Ramanujan birthday magic square. Now I will explain how in general a birthday magic square was framed. Next slide, madam. This is the birthday magic square which suits for every individual. D, M, C, Y, those are the first row elements. D indicates date, M indicates month, C century, and Y indicates year. In the second row elements are Y plus 1, C minus 1, M minus 3, and D plus 3. What is the logic lying behind this? If some number is added, the same number may be subtracted. Similarly, if 3 is subtracted, then 3 is also added so that the sum remains the same. So either in a row or in a column, the logic lying behind this is if some number is added, the same number may be subtracted so that the sum remains the same, and also the sum of every row or the sum of every column and also the sum of the principal diagonal elements will also be the same. So it suits for every individual's birthday. The students also, they enjoyed a lot and overwhelmed with joy how math is connected to their life. Next slide, man. Next one. Now the challenges. Adaptation for specific dates. Each birth date presents a unique challenge in constructing a magic square. And the complexity of computation is calculating the numerical values to fill the squares while maintaining the magic square properties can be computationally intensive. Next, understanding of magic square properties. Students may face challenges in comprehending the mathematical principles underlying magic squares, particularly in relation to their properties and the constraints imposed by the magic square rules. Next, madam. Now, the computational thinking plays a significant role. First, decomposition, breaking down the problem of generating birthday magic squares into smaller, manageable tasks, such as generating a standard magic square. Next, pattern recognition, identifying patterns in magic square construction algorithms and understanding the unique constraints of birthday magic squares. The abstracting away unnecessary details and focusing on the essential elements of the problem. Next slide, madam. Algorithm design, designing algorithms to generate birthday magic squares efficiently, considering factors such as computational complexity. Next, algorithmic thinking, applying logical reasoning to devise strategies for constructing birthday magic squares. Debugging and testing, iteratively testing and debugging the implementation to identify and fix errors, ensuring that the final solution produces valid birthday magic squares. Next, the impact, eager participation. Students eagerly participated in discussions, asking insightful questions and sharing their ideas. Now, hands-on exploration, and also the articulating thought processes. Students, naturally, they express their doubts and articulate the processes involved and understand the logic lying behind this. Next, ma'am. Students' responses in terms of interest. Increased engagement through personalization. I loved how we used our own birthdays to make the magic squares. It made the math feel personal and more interesting to me. Creating a magic square with my birth date made me more invested in solving the problem. Enhancing problem solving skills. It was challenging to figure out how to arrange the numbers to make the sums work, but it really pushed me to think critically. At first, I did not know where to start, but working through the steps to create the magic square improved my problem solving skills. Next, collaborative learning. Working with my classmates to create these magic squares was great. We shared different strategies and helped each other understand the concept together. So students actually, they enjoyed a lot while this activity was conducted in the classroom, and they shared their ideas that how math is connected to their own life, so they enjoyed a lot. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you very much. Any questions for her?
Did any children try 6x6 magic squares? You are showing 6x6 in one of the pictures, so only 4x4, but okay, fine.
Thank you. Next presentation will be by Ravi Prashant on Fractions Made Easy. He'll be presenting online. Hello. Since the presenter is not available online, maybe we can call Jam to talk something about gaming.
This was not about gaming. This is about that particular Hemlata ma'am's presentation with those boxes. Bindu asked the question, how the boxes come, how those numbers come, right? So I would like to tell you that, in fact, you have the numbers at your fingertips. You know that? Okay, let's see. You actually have it in your fingertips. You want to try? Okay, here is zero. Okay, this is zero. This is one. See, she had six boxes. I have only five fingers. So I'm going to go only till 31. Okay. So zero. Yeah, show me. Zero. Okay. One. Two. Two. Yeah, this is two, no? Three. Three. Four. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, come on, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Now, can somebody note down the finger, the numbers for which this finger is up? That's box one. What are the numbers for which this finger is up? Box two. This finger. Okay, now once again. Now please, let your fingers hurt a bit. I mean, children will have no problem with your fingers. Okay, zero. Zero. One. Two. Two. Two plus one is three. So three is clear, right? Okay. Four. Five. Four plus one is five. Six. That's four plus two. Seven. Four plus two plus one is seven. Eight. Yeah? What is nine? Eight plus one. What is ten? Eight plus two. What is 11? Eight plus two plus one. Some fingers are not up. What is 12? Eight plus four. Yeah? 13, 14, yeah, 14, 8 plus 4 plus 2, 15, 16, 17, 18, and this is a little painful, 19, 16 plus 2 plus 1, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 24, 16 plus 8, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Okay, so now you can see that the one great way to play this game is to have five children standing. One child acts as the little finger, one child acts as the ring finger, one as the middle finger, one as, and ask them to put their hands up and down. Right. So what is the rule for the last child, the little finger child? What's the rule? What are the numbers on which your this thing is? Odd numbers. So you just have a whistle. Whistle is great. For every blow of the whistle, up, down, up, down, up, down. That's all. What about this child? Two down, two up, two down, two up. What about this child? Four down, four up, four down. Eight down, eight up. 16 down, 16 up. That's it. But that's also too much counting. Can you make it simpler? What is the rule for this child? Up, down, up, down. What about for this child? We said two down, two up and so on, no? Can we make it simpler? Okay. So, this is eight, no? What is seven? 4 plus 2 plus 1. Do you see some pattern? What is 16? This is 16. What is 15? 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. Okay. What is 4? This. What is 3? These two. So, the rule is, when do you put your hand up? You keep your hand down. When all the hands to your right are up, ask them to put it down and you put your hand up. When should you put it down? You don't have to think about it. Somebody will tell you. Right? So what all you need to do is to look to your, keep looking to your right. When all the hands go up, ask them to put it down, you put your hand up. And then you keep waiting for somebody to tell you. Okay, now, so here is one algorithm, right? So you've turned it into some very simple rule that children can play. Now for those who want to think about better algorithms, here is a challenge. I mean, here I have to see all the hands to my right, right? Suppose I can't. I can only see only to my left and right. What instructions would you give? Do you see? The question is, so look through all those patterns. There is a very nice pattern. And you have the answer. Okay.
Thank you.
So Ravi Prasad sir is waiting to be made a panelist. 2 minutes. He is waiting as participant.
Ravi Prasad. He was waiting as a final
presentation.
How do I take it to the classroom? Right? So you are going to get a hands-on experience in all the activities outside, spend time, enjoy, and the session will start at 3. We'll go through tea break till 4:30. So you have 1.5 hours, otherwise I feel bad ushering everybody inside. Right? And at 4:30, we are going to have the last session, which is going to be presented by the academia and organizations who are there. So 4:30 to 6, we'll finish that. And I don't know if Ashokji is here, but he has also said after that session you can go to Science Activity Center and join us for dinner at 7:30.
Chai at 4.
Chai at 4 and chai at 6.
Collect 10 watches of the presenters, you'll get chai.
Yeah, so, no, there are two chai. There is chai at 4 and there is chai at 6. Okay? So, 4. Yeah?
He has started sharing already.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir. Please proceed for your presentation.
Ma'am, I'm saying yes. One second. Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon. My name is Ravi Prashant Tumukudi. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the 6th conference. Ma'am, can you hear me, my voice?
Yeah, we can.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for being today. And welcome to sixth conference on computational thinking in schools. And let me start by saying a few words about myself. I am Ravi Prashant, working as a TGT in mathematics in Chundur Mandalam, Bapalwada district, Andhra Pradesh. And today, my topic is fractions made easy. And as we know that a fraction is used to represent the portion or a part of a whole thing, and it represents the equal parts of the whole. And first, the Egyptians has introduced these fractions, and the number expressed a quotient in which a numerator is divided by a denominator, and in a simple fraction, both are integers, and we know a proper fraction can be written having the numerator is less than the denominator. The students are know about the fractions, how they can write about the fractions, and in general way, in daily routine, how they can use the fractions I just given an activity to do it in their daily routines. Ma'am, just a here is an activity that is expressing time of a whole day activities using fractions. The students have planned their activities like this. Yes, ma'am?
Sir, could you please show your slideshow?
Yes, ma'am, it is there, ma'am. Is it not displaying, ma'am?
Yeah, could you please? Zoom.
Is it?
Zoom.
He's not able to press. So let him continue.
Yeah, could you please continue? Means there is a slideshow, right? Could you please click on that? Will that be possible? Or else you can proceed. Yeah, you can proceed. Sir?
Ma'am?
Ravi Prakash, sir?
Ma'am?
Please proceed.
Tell me, ma'am.
Yeah, we can see the screen now. You can proceed.
Is my students plan the whole day activity like this? The sleeping time, they are taken 8 hours, and time spent in school 6 hours, and time spent for study 4 hours, playing time 3 hours, regular activities 2 hours, and other activities 1 hour. They planned like this, and they represented this daily activities through a picture like this. They had prepared a rectangle, and they divided it into 24 equal parts. And each part they have taken as a 1 hour. And first, for the sleeping time, they have taken 8 hours. Time spent as a 6 hours like that. Now in this picture, the first one, they have taken 8 parts colored out of 24, which represents time spent for sleeping. And then in next picture, they have colored 14. In that, the 6 parts have colored in blue, where it time spent for school, time spent in school. Next, in the next picture, 16 parts are colored out of 24, where green represents time spent for regular activities. And in next picture, 20 parts are colored out of 24, red represents time spent for study. And then next, 23 parts are colored out of 24, where yellow represents the time spent on sleeping. And the final picture, where the 24 parts are colored, and the 24 last part, that is one purple, will be represent time spent in other activities. Finally, with the color indication in the picture represents that the yellow, I mean the orange or the saffron, where it represents the time spent for sleeping. Blue represents time spent in school, red represents time spent for study, where yellow represents time spent on playing, green represents time spent on regular activities, purple represents time spent on other activities. They have planned like this, their daily routine by using fraction, they pictured and they colored like this. And in this activity, for doing activity, they have used the strategies in computational thinking were data collection, analyzing data, and algorithm. Students collected the data, that means how they allotted the time for doing their daily activities, that is data collection, and then they analyze the data, and then they will write the step-by-step procedure for doing this activity, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you. We'll ask if any questions are there for you.
Oh, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Any questions for Ravi Prakash? No. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am, for giving me this opportunity. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Bye. Would like to call Yogesh Sharma.
I am stopping my screen sharing, madam. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Brinda Patel. Satish Kumar. Hemalata. Jayalakshmi. Sudharani. Thank you so much. I have two more certificates, Ratna Kumari and Sirisha. Could you please? Okay, Sirisha. Okay, thanks. What's the next?
3 to 4 posters.
So now we will go out and have the poster session now. Thank you. 4 to 4:30. We'll be back by tea break. So we'll be coming back by 4:30.